In this video, we're going to take a look at how to do application problems that involve the normal distribution. So basically, we'll be taking a look at how to do problems where we will obtain z-scores and use normal CDF to come up with probabilities under the standard normal curve, but there will be some kind of imposed structure on top of that. There'll be a word problem type of structure. So we'll actually be trying to answer an applied problem. So we're looking at application problems for normal distributions. And generally speaking, there is a helpful kind of process for doing an application problem that involves a normal distribution. The first thing that you want to do is you want to check to make sure a normal distribution applies. To the scenario that you're working with. If nothing in the problem talks about the data being normally distributed or mound-shaped and symmetric or bell-shaped, or if you haven't followed the instructions in the book for checking to make sure that the data follow a normal distribution, then there's really no reason to believe that a normal distribution applies, and therefore you wouldn't necessarily be using these particular methods. If, on the other hand, you know or you're reasonably sure that a normal distribution does apply to the scenario that you're dealing with, then you would proceed with the rest of the steps. The second step is to take the values of interest, or to take the raw values of interest, the x values, and convert these to z-scores. Using the formula, z is equal to x minus mu over sigma. Okay, so here's our formula that we'll use to convert from raw values or x values into the z scores or standard scores. And then 3, in the calculator, we will use normal CDF to obtain the desired probability. And that's basically the steps for doing any kind of application problem. So we were looking at examples with the distribution of IQ scores. And we'll just go back to that because it's a handy problem to discuss. So let's say, again, we're dealing with IQ scores, and we know they follow a normal curve. With a mean of 100 and a standard deviation of 15. Okay, so that's just given. And let's say we select an individual at random. What is the probability that and let's say in part A, their IQ is between 90 and 122. Okay, so that's what I want to know. We're going to select an individual at random. What's the probability that they have an IQ that's between 90 and 122? So notice that this is not a problem that we can answer directly with the empirical rule, because these do not fall on nice numbers of standard deviations away from the mean of the distribution. Okay, so if we're going to follow that process I just talked about, first, Check your scenario to make sure that a normal distribution applies. Well, it says right here, IQ scores follow a normal curve. So we can be sure that a normal distribution applies. Then we want to take the raw values of interest, that's these guys, the x values, and convert them to z-scores using the formula x minus mu over sigma. Okay, so for each of these two values, we're going to find its associated z-score. So x, that's the 90, minus mu, 100, divided by sigma, 15. And then when you do these, 90 minus 100 over 15, you'll get a decimal. In this case, it's a negative 0.6 repeating. The book will follow the historical convention of rounding z-scores to two decimal places. And the book will also follow the convention of keeping the probabilities when you get them at the end to four decimal places. Now, if you want to round your probabilities to less than four places, that's perfectly fine. But I would recommend keeping at least two places in the z-score, or if you want it to match up with exactly what the back of the book has, keep exactly two places for your z-score. If you start rounding there, you're going to end up with slightly different values in the back of the book, and it makes it tougher to check your answers. We also need to convert the value of 122. So 122 minus 100 divided by 15. And when we do that, we get a 1.46 repeating. The 6 repeats there. So approximately 1.47. And so this original statement asking for the probability that the x value is between 90 and 122. In z-score format, what that looks like is asking for the probability that z is between negative 0.67 and 1.47. Okay, it's the exact same statement, it's just here it is in terms of raw scores, an IQ between 90 and 122. In terms of standard scores, we're talking about being negative 0.67 away from the mean in terms of standard deviations, and 1.47 away from the mean. We'll put these values into normal CDF, which again you can make a sketch here if you want to, just so you can compare. So if I want to shade in the area of interest, negative 0.67 is going to be about here, 1.47 is going to be about here, and this is the area that I'm looking at. Excuse me. So then we're just going to plug that into normal CDF in the calculator, the way that I showed you in the other video. So we'll go second vars to our distributions menu, select the second option, normal CDF, put in your values, negative 0.67 and 1.47, and crunch that through, and we get about 68%. Okay, so about 68% chance that a randomly selected individual will have an IQ between 90 and 122. And that's the basic idea with the application problems. That's this type of an application problem, where you're coming up with the probability of a particular event. In the next video, we'll take a look at another type of application problem that's commonly termed a guarantee problem, and it has a little bit different approach.